Hi, Skude.
Hey.
So, we're sitting here, and right now we're in Team Singularity's boot camp. Tell me a little bit about this boot camp, and what do you think about Team Singularity's facilities?
The boot camp is really nice. The PCs are like the best I've played on, and we have 20 ping, so I can't play a better solo queue than here, and also competitive. Even though we lost the other day, but it happens. The owner is really nice. He paid all our food and he drove us to the hotel back and forth. I've really enjoyed it here. Even though we've only been two people because Corona and visa issues and everything, but me and Riva have learned a lot here and we've improved a lot together as a duo. So we will be way better during the end of the split for sure, as a mid jungle.
Tell me a little bit, like we played Ents this week. We lost. Yeah. Tell me a little, what do you think about Ents and what do you think about their team?
I respect their top laner a lot, Nille, because he was on our team last split and I know he's like one of the best top laners in the league. Also Kevo, I see a lot of potential in him. And the rest, the other three, I don't really know that well, but I really like Kevo and Nille and I think they have so much potential and they're a strong opponent for sure.
If we go to the next opponent and let's take it from the top of the list, we have the academy team, BTXL.
Yeah.
What do you think of XL and what do you expect from our matches against them?
I think they have a lot of synergy because they've played together so long, even though they have a new mid laner. And they have like a really good understanding of how to play their style and how to use their strong carries, which is Deadly and Hatchfix. And Jacing like really knows how to move on the map, so we need to be well prepared and have good starting and preparation. I think we can show them, we can take the fight to them for sure. Like through our practice we've showed a lot of potential against the good Grimms, but it hasn't really come out in our competitive games. But I think it will be a hard game, but I think we can show some good things.
Cutting back into it, we have at the top of the leaderboard after the two first weeks, we have Riddle. The Norwegian organization with the Danish team that also features I from our team last bit. What do you think about this this Danish squad?
I think they are really good and they're all friends, so they will never have like real arguments. So I think the training is running really fast, but I'm not sure how they will improve during the split. It depends on their mindset or if they just become too much friends and just fuck around. I know Raya and Vindelbo from, I played with them. I played with Vindelbo at LAN for Riddle before, a few years ago. And I've known Raya for quite a while from Unicorns and they split. All the players are really skilled and I think it will be really hard to beat. Especially in match LOL, because he's played in academies and he's really good on the current meta change. So it will be a hard matchup, but I think I can take it to him if I have my dream.
Sweet.
Also, I know Riddle's ownership for quite a while, and I'm really good friends with the owner, so I'm really hyped to play against them and beat them.
No, that sounds great. I'm looking forward to see that match. it sounds like it's predicted to be intense anyway.
It's gonna be fun for me for sure. Yeah.
So the other two teams left in our group is Godsend and Nordavent. Let's start by Nordavent, since that was the first match we had of the season. Tell me a little bit about Nordavent. Tell me a little bit about what you expect going into our, let's say, revenge match in the second part of the split.
I felt like we didn't do anything last time. We just played way too safe and way too chill. And next time we will come in swinging and we will show them that we can beat them. And they play like really slow and they play very controlled. And if we play our style, I don't think they will be able to match us. If they get to like use Crisberg as he wants, then he can be really hyper carry and it's a bit scary to play against, but I think we can shut it down if we play our game.
In the first week of the split, we lost against Godsend, a team I know you had predicted that we would do better against, but we had a bad day, it looked like. Tell me a little bit about that matchup and also what you expect from the rematch?
I mean, again, we just scared again to play our game, and we tried to match what they were doing, and we didn't play what we wanted ourselves. So we just looked really lost in the map, and we're just better players, but we just were scared for no reason at all. We just respected them too much, and I think they're not that good, to be honest. Like, I've beat Seabar before at LAN, I know all the players, and I don't see anything special there. We just had a really shitty day, and incident, and didn't play our game, to be honest.
While we're on the subject, of course we're just one of the groups, and there's another group. If you should highlight one or two teams from the other group, that you expect that will qualify at least for playoffs.
Yeah.
Who do you predict from the other group will claim the top of the leaderboard?
Fnatic Academy for sure, and I think Munster as well. They have so many good still players and so much support staff, so much experience and drive and mechanics. So I think they will pull through. Yeah.
NLC. This is the inaugural league. This is the first season of the NLC.
Yeah.
Tell me a little bit about the new format, and tell me what your thoughts were upon this new league format and UK and Nordics combining.
I like the format a lot, and I really like the way you can get relegated if you are best, because then newer teams that are up and coming can qualify, and it's not really locked in, so you need to really fight no matter how good you are. Also, combining the league and making it way bigger is so hype, because now there's actually good players coming to Nordic and it's gonna be competitive. I don't like the way there's only two spots for EU Masters, but can't really do much about it. I think a lot of people have complained as well, but it is how it is, and we just need to have two good teams perform really well in new masters, and we get more spots for next split. Yeah, pretty much it. I really like the new league they made.
Yeah, no, I'm happy to hear that, and same for me. I really believe it's healthy for the development of the scene here in the Nordics.
Yeah, I mean, Nordic has so much talent, so it should be a big league for sure.
To switch to something else, tell me a little bit about how is a day in your life, both of course in terms of practice and all this stuff, but I'm more interested to hear what happens outside of your gaming life.
I started going to the gym recently with my brother. He's studying how to train and stuff, so he helped me out, and I go for daily walks. I made food with my mom. We eat together as a family, and we just chill, play some games sometimes. And I also meditate sometimes, which is pretty good for me. And then I sleep a lot. And that's pretty much it. And then I play League all day, kind of. Yeah, pretty much it.
Doesn't sound like a bad day.
No, it's just chilling, living life.
Chilling, living life.
Wow. Chilling.
Yeah. Team Singularity, your I'd call you one of the legacy players in terms of league. Can you tell me, can you kind of pull me through, if you can remember everything, your legacy here in Team Singularity?
I remember 2 years ago when I joined the first time. I had my doubts about joining. I didn't believe in the players that much. But as we played more together, it just became so fun, and the owner supported us through everything. And we won for him, so he respects us a lot, and yeah, I like it here. It feels like you can put your word out there and he will listen to you, and you're respected no matter what you say. It's just overall nice, and yeah, I don't know what else to say.
How much have you won while you're here? I remember 2 years ago when we started, you basically won the Danish league.
Yeah,
three times in a row, I think.
Two times. We won the most stacked LCD, Leeds Denmark, Danish League, two times. Where there was really good players, but now it's kind of a bit lower. And then we won Nordic Championship last bit, of course, and yeah, we've only won on this team, or I've only won on Singularity. So I hope we can do this well in NLC. It's not looking the best right now, but I believe we can at least get some wins under our belt for this bit.
Turn it around.
Yeah.
Sounds good. No, but Skude, thank you so much. Anything else you want to share with us? Mm. Any player you want to highlight?
I think Riva will surprise a lot of people. A lot of people have doubts about him, but during this bootcamp and during the last weeks of scrims, we have really pulled through and he's shown a lot. And I believe he will perform really well the next coming weeks.
Sweet. So are we going to see an upset against XL or Riddle? Is that what you're...
That's the goal, yeah.
That's the goal?
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess our best chance is against probably Riddle, since they just lost to Godsend.
Yeah, I mean, it just sounds like Godsend is the best team in the league.
Almost.
Yeah,
like,
I mean, they beat Riddle, which is really favorite, so...
Yeah.
I guess.
And yeah, you know the Danish guys just as well as I do. They might tilt over stuff like that. And like a bad loss like that can really spiral a lot in a friend's teams.
Yeah,
like
it
that,
can.
Like that.
But I also think I know them well enough that they will just laugh it off and go next.
Yeah. And then if they lose again, it's gonna go full frustrating mode.
Yeah, who knows?
Nah, but yeah, Skude, thank you for this time, and go enjoy the rest of your day.
Yeah, thank you.
See you, man.
See ya.